In today's video, we are going to learn about helping verb, was and were. So let's begin it. Before I start using of was and were, use of was and were, let me remind you what are helping verb. Helping verbs are the verbs which connects subject to the action word, or you can say which connect subject to the main verb. In order to link subject to the main verb, we need a helping verb, and that makes the correct sense of the sentence. So, as I told you that we are going to learn about use of was and were. Helping verb, was and were. These are yesterday word. In short, you can remember it as these are yesterday words. Yesterday word means if your action is happened, if your action happened in the past, then remember, we always use helping verb was and were. As in previous video, I told you that we use is, am, are. These helping verb is, am, are, they are used when your action happened in the present. And those are called as now words. In the same way, was and were are called as yesterday word. They denotes that action happened in the past. So whenever in a sentence, if you find action happened in the past, then it means you have to use the helping verb was and were. And also remember, where do we use were, where do we have to use was, and where do we have to use were. Remember, when your subject is singular, if in a sentence subject is single, then you have to use the helping verb was. And also see the action is happened in the past. Action should happen in the past. Then only you can use the helping verb was. And where do we use were? When your subject is plural. If the subject is plural, then we use helping verb were. Now we'll learn more about it through some exercises. So let's do some exercises now. Here the first exercise is fill in the blanks with was and were. Here you have to fill all these blanks using the helping verb was and were. So just keep in mind that your subject should be single and your action should be in the past. So let's see. First is the knife dash sharp, but the scissors dash blunt. Here your subject, firstly we need to see the subject. Here the subject is knife. So knife is single knife, so we will use the helping verb was. So we'll write here the knife was sharp, but the scissors dash blunt. But the scissors were blunt. Secondly, as it is in plural form. Secondly, the giant dash very cruel. What do we have to write? We'll use the helping verb was as the subject is single. The giant, it is single. Giant was very cruel. Those mangoes dash ripe. Mangoes, it's in plural form. So we will use the helping verb were. So we'll write here were. Those mangoes were ripe. Next, the hippopotamus dash eating potatoes. So here the subject is singular. Hippopotamus, single is there. So we'll write here was. The hippopotamus was eating potatoes. Next, grandmother dash knitting pullovers for us. So here the subject, grandmother, it is in single form. So we'll write here, grandmother was knitting pullovers for us. We dash so happy. We reveals the plural pronoun. So it means subject is plural. So here we will write we were. We were so happy. Next, Geeta and I dash eating pizza. Here Geeta and I, here two persons are there at subject place. So what helping verb we have to use? We have to use Geeta and I were. Geeta and I were eating pizza. Where dash you last night? Where dash you last night? As I told you that when your subject is single, we use was. But here, where dash you, whenever your subject is you, you can be singular, you can be plural. So for that, Whenever you find you anywhere and your action is in the past form, you always have to use was with us. You always have to use were before along with the you. For you, you will use the helping verb were if your sentence is in the past form. So what do we have to write here? Where were you last night? Remember, if your sentence is in the past form, as here it is written last night. Last night means the night before the day. So it means it is in the past form. So here along with you, we always write were if your sentence is in the past form. So where were you last night? I-worried about you. Here you can see the action word is in the past form, worried. Worried means the action has already happened. So it means I-worried about you. So along with I, we always write was. I was worried about you. Next is Shweta-sleeping when I came. When I came means that action has already happened and your subject is singular, Shweta, only single girl is there. So we'll write here Shweta was sleeping when I came. Why-she sobbing yesterday? Why was she? Why? Because she is the singular pronoun here, singular subject is here. So we'll write here why was she sobbing yesterday? And you can see that yesterday is written here. Yesterday means the sentence is in the past form, that is day before today, right? They dash in the park a little while ago. They, it means it is a plural pronoun, so subject is plural. So we'll write here they were in the park little while ago. Little while ago means just few minutes back, right? So it means it is in past form. Next sentence, it is it dash very hot and humid yesterday. Again, you can see the word yesterday, it means it's a past form. So what do we have to write? It was. Along with it, we always write was as it is a singular pronoun. So it was very hot and humid yesterday. Who dash your class teacher in class 2? So what I have to write? Who was? Class teacher could be only one teacher. So it is a singular subject. So what I have to write? Who was your class teacher in class 2? Next is the piper dash playing a sweet tune on his pipe. The piper. So it means it's a singular person. So we'll write here the piper was playing sweet tune on his pipe. Next, Subhash Chandra Bose dash was a great freedom fighter. So what I have to write here? Was. Because Subhash Chandra Bose, a singular subject is here, singular person is here. So we'll write here Subhash Chandra Bose was a great freedom fighter. Next, the sun dash hiding behind the clouds. Sun, the only sun is there. So it means we have to write past form helping verb was. The sun was hiding behind the clouds. There dash some books on the table. There dash some books. It means your subject is plural, books. So it means we have to write there were some books on the table. Next, Swami Vivekanand dash very popular among the people. Swami Vivekanand, the single person. So subject is singular. So we have to write Swami Vivekanand was very popular among the people. We dash enjoying ourselves at the party. We, it means plural pronoun or plural subject. We'll write here we were enjoying ourselves at the party. Dash you confused on this topic? Here, as I told you that whenever you is there and your action word is in the past form, then along with you, you always have to write were, right? So we'll write here, were you confused on this topic? Next, dash he proud of his power? Here the subject is he. So he is a singular subject. So we'll write here, was he proud of his power? The next exercise. In this exercise, some options are given in brackets and you have to write the correct options in the blanks. So first one is it dash a pleasant trip was or were, which option we have to write. So firstly we'll see that this sentence is already sorry, now the next exercise is here in all these blanks some options are given and you have to find out the correct option and fill it over there, right? The first one is it dash a pleasant trip and options are given was or were. So what I have to write here, you have to see the subject. Your subject is singular, it. It is used for single thing, so it means it is a single trip, right? It was they are talking about a single trip, so it means it is a singular subject. It is used as a singular subject, so we have to write it was a pleasant trip, right? Here it is not written trips, so it means it is they are talking about the single trip, so it was a pleasant trip, right? So we have to write it was a pleasant trip. Secondly, Jantar Mantar dash a famous monument, and option is given is or was. Now how I would know that whether I have to write is or was? What you have to do, you have to see the sentences in present form or the past form, then only you can find which option would be the correct. So Jantar Mantar, this monument is present at the moment, right? So this is already here, it means this sentence is in the present form. So we'll write here Jantar Mantar is a famous monument because it is existing now also, right? Today I dash unwell. Today I was or am. If I am saying that today, it means I am talking about the present day. So it means it is in the present form. This sentence is talking about now, right? So we have to write the helping verb am. So when we talk about the present form, present day, we always put am along with I, right? So here I will write today I am unwell. So today reveals that we are talking about the present day. Next is he dash having toothache last night. When we talk about last night means previous day, right? Previous night. So here options are given was and is. So last night reveals that the sentence is in the past form. That action happened already. So we have to write he was having toothache last night. It means previous day. Next is the puppet show dash awesome. The puppet show dash awesome. It means the show has been seen by the persons, those who have seen it. So it means that action has already happened. So the puppet show was awesome. We praise when we saw that. Right? So it means we have to write the puppet show was awesome. Right? And how do I know that? The puppet show. We are talking about the single puppet show. Right? We are not talking about puppet shows. So it is a singular subject. We have to write the puppet show was awesome. Right? Why dash you making a noise? Now options are is and are. Both are in the present form. Now how I would know that I have to use is or are? How I would know that? I told you that when your sentence is in the present form, when your action reveals that the action is happening now. So you have to use always are with the you. Whenever your pronoun is you, whenever your subject is you, you have to use are, right? Along with you in present form, we use are, and in past form, we use were, right? So here the sentence is in present form, and how I would know that? Because here it is written making, right? So why dash you making a noise, and options are given in present form actually. So that's why we have to write is or are, we have to write are, because options are already given in the present form, right? So we have to write why are you making a noise. Next is the teacher dash watching you. The teacher was watching you or is watching you. How I would know that? As the sentence already begin with the present form, so here I have to use the present action word, means now word I have to use. Now helping verb I have to use, that is. So teacher is watching you. Even yesterday, now yesterday means past form, previous day. Even yesterday you dash disturbing the class. So here are and were are the option. So as I told you that here yesterday word is used. means the previous day. So here I will use were. Why? Whenever past form is there along with you, we always write were. So we'll write here, even yesterday you were disturbing the class. Next, Rina and I dash good friend, and options are am and are. Rina and I are good friend, right? Because it is in present form. And two persons are there, and options are along with I. And here two persons are there. At subject place, we are having two persons, so that's why I have written are. Next is, we dash celebrating Holi in our colony. Was or were? We dash Holi in our colony. So we is a plural subject, so we'll write here, we were celebrating Holi in our colony. Dash you wasting water. Was or were? So as I told you that whenever you is there, we have to write were if the sentence is in the past form. So we'll write here, were you wasting water? Next, no, all of the kids dash throwing flower petals and natural colors at each other. And options are was and were. So all of the kids, it means the subject is in plural form and sentence is already, options are already in the past form. So we'll write here, was or were? We'll write here, were. Why? Because here subject is plural. So we'll write here, all of the kids were throwing flowers and flower petals and natural colors at each other. The sun dash shining and the fog dash disappearing. And options are was and were. So what I have to write? Sun, singular subject. So I'll write, the sun was shining and the fog is also singular. So we'll write here, the fog was disappearing, right? Dash the train on time. It means options are in present form. So we'll write here, is or are? We'll write here, is the train. Why? Because the train is singular subject here, right? We are talking about single train. So we'll write here, is the train on time? So in this exercise, we learned about that how do we use the present, or you can say the now helping verb, or you can say how do we use the yesterday helping verb. So now helping verb are is, am, are, and yesterday helping verb are was and were, right? So I hope it is clear. Now we'll do the next exercise. In this exercise, it's a fun time. So let's do some fun time. Here in all these words, some words are hidden, right? And you have to find out that hidden words. And in order to find the hidden words, some hints are given which hidden word is there, right? So let's find out. First one is already done. In often, we can see 10. You can see that 10 is written here, right? And it is a number. Hint is given a number. So we are easily able to find that. Similarly, in other words, we'll find out through these hints. Secondly, it is spring. So we have to find the name of an ornament. So we can find the name of ornament is a ring here. You can see R-I-N-G, ring, right? It's an ornament that we wear in our fingers. Grass. In grass, you have to find the name of an animal. So we can find the name of an animal that is ass. Right? Ass is an animal. Honest. In this word, we have to find a bird's home. So what do we call the bird's home? It's nest. N-E-S-T, nest. Shop. Here, we have to find action word jump. What is another word we use for jump? That is hop. So we have to write hop. H-O-P, hop. Elephant. Here, we have to find the hidden word. That is an insect, small insect. So that is ant. Ant is an insect, so we'll write it ant. Garden, and hint is given, a lion's home. And what do we call a lion's home? That is den. So we can see D-E-N, den. So we'll write it here. Next, appear. Here we have to find the name of fruit. So name of fruit is pear, P-E-A-R. So we will write it here. That was the fun time. So I hope you all understood where we use helping verb was and were, right? Whenever your subject is single, we use was. Whenever your subject is plural, we use were. And your sentence should be in the past form, right? And how do you know that the sentence is in the past form? You have to see that your action should be done previously. Your action should be done in past way, right?
If your action has done in the past, then you means then you can easily reveal that the sentence is in the past form. And where do we use the helping verb is am are? They are the now helping verb, means they are used when your action is happening at present. When your action happens at present moment, then you use the helping verb is am are. And when your subject is single, you use is. When your subject is plural, we use are in present form of sentences, right? And we use am when your subject is I, right? And always we use are with you when your sentence is in the present form. I hope you all clearly understood the concept of helping verb is am are and was were. So that's all in this video. Thank you.